Hey there, story lovers. Welcome to chapter 3 of our thrilling tale. Today, we're diving into the heart of Aspen, where emotions run high and the stakes are even higher. Picture this. A town square alive with the flickering glow of torches, the air thick with anticipation as the townsfolk gather. The biting cold is a constant reminder of the winter spirit's looming presence. At the forefront stands Lila, her heart racing with the weight of her newfound abilities. Beside her, Ethan exudes a quiet strength, though his warm smile hints at uncertainty. Behind them, an ice sculpture looms, a haunting reflection of their collective grief. Buckle up, because this chapter is about to take us on a roller coaster of emotions and revelations. As the sun dips below the horizon, casting long shadows across the square, Lila feels the spirit's energy pulsating through the ground. It's a rhythmic heartbeat that resonates with her own. She closes her eyes, drawing strength from the very essence of winter. "We have to confront it together," Lila whispers, her voice barely audible over the murmurs of the crowd. Ethan nods, his dark hair catching the last rays of sunlight, determination flickering in his warm brown eyes. The townsfolk, once divided by their fears, begin to unite. Mr. Thompson, the town's historian, steps forward, his weathered face etched with lines of sorrow and wisdom. "We must face the spirit not as individuals, but as a community. Only then can we heal the wounds of our past," he urges, his voice steady yet filled with emotion. With a collective breath, the townsfolk form a circle around the ice sculpture, their hands clasped tightly together. Lila and Ethan stand at the center, their hearts beating in sync, a beacon of hope amidst the encroaching darkness. The air crackles with energy as the winter spirit materializes, its form shifting between menacing and serene, reflecting the townsfolk's fears and hopes. "You cannot hide from your grief," the spirit's voice echoes, a haunting melody that sends shivers down their spines. Lila steps forward, her blue eyes blazing with determination. "We are not afraid. We embrace our past, and we will not let you consume us." Her words ring out, a clarion call that resonates with the hearts of the townsfolk. Ethan joins her, his voice steady. "Together, we can transform this pain into strength. We will not let our sorrow define us." The spirit pauses, its icy visage softening as it absorbs their resolve. The townsfolk, emboldened by Lila and Ethan's courage, begin to chant, their voices rising in unison, a powerful anthem of acceptance and unity. As the spirit's form flickers, Lila feels a surge of warmth within her, a flicker of hope igniting in the depths of her heart. The ice sculpture begins to melt, the tears of the townsfolk washing away the burdens of the past. In that moment, Lila understands that true strength lies not in the absence of fear, but in the willingness to confront it together. The spirit, once a harbinger of despair, begins to transform, its icy exterior giving way to a radiant glow, a guardian reborn from the ashes of grief. The town of Aspen stands united, their hearts intertwined, ready to embrace the future with open arms. The embers of hope flicker brightly, illuminating the path toward healing and redemption. And there you have it, folks, another chapter wrapped up with a bow of unity and hope. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and join us next time on Storyteller for more adventures.